Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today's video is going to be a complete guide on how to play Dirac. In my opinion, Dirac is one of the best mages in Arena of Valor who has a lot of crowd control and a huge damage output, which are all essential qualities for a very good mage. In this video, we'll be talking about all the different abilities of Dirac and how you can make the best use of them. Now, if you are a new Dirac player and if you find this guide helpful, support me by hitting the subscribe button and let me know in the comments what other hero tutorials you would like to see. We also have a Zata and Florentino tutorial in the channel, so if you are interested in them, do check out those videos. Now without further ado, let's get right into the guide. Dirac will not die when his HP reaches 0. But instead, his mana will take damage and each point of mana is equal to 1 damage. This makes it very hard for assassins to kill Dirac in the late game because his mana provides him a lot more HP and makes him a lot tankier. Here is a demonstration of how much Dirac can survive in a team fight by using his mana. Dirac launches a globe which pushes the nearby enemies and travels in a straight line, dealing damage to all the enemies in its path. This ability is the core damage ability of Dirac and is also one of his most important crowd controls. This ability provides Dirac with a lot of wave clear so that he can rotate to other lines before the enemy mage. Unlocking his S2 provides Dirac with more vision than any other hero. You have to place your S2 and then direct it to push the enemies where you want them. His S2 hits the enemy 3 times but only the first time pushes them. However, if you use your S2 to push the enemy towards an obstacle, it will stun them 3 times. You can use this ability in pair with your S1 to stun them in a place and deal the damage. The most important thing about his S2 is that if you push an enemy towards an obstacle with your S2, it marks them. If your S1 hits an enemy who has been marked by the S2, it instantly refreshes the cooldown of your S1. Therefore, if you are being chased by a warrior or an assassin, try to run close to a wall and then use your S2 and push the assassin towards the wall and use your S1 multiple times. This will stun chain the enemy and they will die or be forced to retreat. Here is a new combo for you guys. If you use your S2 first and instead of pushing the enemy immediately, use your S1 towards them. And when your S1 is about to hit them, use your S2 and push them towards the nearby wall. Doing so will instantly refresh your S1 3 times so that if you keep tapping your ability, you will use it 3 times. Dirac's most significant ability is his ultimate. His ult puts a barrier in front of him which blocks any incoming projectile, ability or marksman bullets. After using the Genesis barrier, 2 seconds later, Dirac can use the Genesis blast to snipe across the map. Only the abilities that are launched or thrown by the opponent and come as projectiles can be blocked by the Genesis barrier. So abilities like Grax's hook cannot be blocked. Another really good example is Natalia. Natalia's first and second ability are thrown by her which are blocked by the barrier, but her ult, since it's connected with her, cannot be blocked. After Dirac uses his ultimate, for a few seconds his auto attacks are enhanced to deal area damage to all the enemies along its path, just like his S1. While diving a tower, if you place your barrier on top of the tower, you can prevent it from attacking in any direction. You can also stand on top of your own barrier to prevent incoming damage from any direction. If you are going to gank the top lane, the enemies will be forced to run towards their tower and they'll be running close to the wall. So you can capitalize this by pushing them towards the wall and using multiple S1s on them. In the bottom lane, this is the brush in which the enemies will be hiding in order to gank the enemy mage who is coming on rotation or to kill the marksman who overextends. But This becomes a very good spot for Dirac to use his combos, and therefore ganking the bottom lane can be more fruitful. That's it for today's video, guys. If you found this guide helpful, make sure to hit the subscribe button and let me know in the comment section what other tutorials you'd like to see.